What did you think of James Lovelock's proposal, or his research at the moment into producing these tubes?
Well, yeah, he was on the news.
The ocean, yeah.
That wasn't his research, though, was it? What did he? I missed no, what well, he said. What did he Lovelock say?
He and someone else, can't remember their name, they jointly had the idea. They started researching it, and they found out that an American company was already. They were already researching it themselves,
right.
And they'd already done tests. So it's like a sort of parallel thinking across the Atlantic. But obviously Lovelock, being an environmental icon as he is, he will be associated with it the most, yeah?
Well, if Lovelock is great. I mean, people should be, going to him for advice. I mean, if anyone has an intimate understanding of the biosphere and the way the biosphere works, and James Lovelock's your man, So...
What do you think of the idea of technological fixes, though? are they going to achieve anything? Because there's been quite a few proposals at the moment, haven't there?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Well, according to Lovelock, we have to. In his Revenge of Gaia book, the situation is critical enough that we have to embark on these radical technological fixes. I mean, he's pro nuclear power and stuff. So,
yeah, that's a contentious issue.
Another contentious issue.
But it possible if it helps reduce.
Well, what I
carbon
thought, when they talk about getting immense amounts of algae to flourish in the ocean, so they can absorb carbon dioxide. One of the films I saw about it, they were saying that they were going to find the equivalent of oceanic deserts, large areas of the ocean where there is very little life, and they were going to put iron in there or something to encourage large amounts of algae to flourish. And that seemed all right, because it's like if you went to the Sahara or some big desert and you reintroduced huge swathes of forest or whatever, ecological engineering, I can't see that would be, if they're natural organisms, I find it difficult to see that would be harmful, as long as it's living, they're living creatures, because you're just increasing the biospherical mat, the carpet of natural intelligence, if you like. So intuitively it sounds like a good idea. So this thing that was on the news that Lovelock commented on, this technological fix, I don't know what oceans they were going to kind of do that in, but I don't know, because someone cautioned at the end, didn't they? Someone said at the end that, well, we don't know what long-term effects this might have if we interfere. So I don't know, but people like Lovelock, they're the ones to ask about that.
Yeah, but there's always effects, isn't there, with technological fixes, I guess.
It can't be, when you think about it, it can't be any worse than what we're doing, driving millions of cars every day and stuff.
Yeah.
That goes on all the time. That's sort of a negative thing. So if you suddenly start creating more life, more organisms, more, huge swathes of metabolizing organisms, maybe it will be okay.
Yeah.
And the any negative effects will be negligible. But I don't know. It's uncertain.
Because this ties in with the green tide proposal, really. Because if you're thinking of reintroducing greenery into London en masse, or any city en masse.
Urban greening.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Urban greening. That could only have a positive effect, except for maybe on the water table, as you pointed out.
Yeah.
It would take a lot of water in the summer.
Yeah, I think the positive effects would be much, would outweigh the negative effects. So yeah, Ian's referring to on the Psychoactive Media webpage, we've got a green tide proposal, which is about greening urban areas. We're in cities where you've got all this concrete, all this surface area that's just concrete. It'd be good, and the budgets are there to have plants everywhere, so there's just plants and trees and ivy and stuff growing all over cities, and that would help to it would help absorb carbon from the carbon dioxide, and b, it would also increase biodiversity, insects and whack, because people are putting concrete over their gardens and stuff. So I think that would be good, the green tide proposal, but that wouldn't, it would be kind of a negligible thing. That the thing they want to do in the oceans with algae, that's quite a, probably be quite a significant, more of a significant impact on absorbing carbon.
I don't know. It depends on the scale, really, doesn't it? I mean, if they're talking about 10 square kilometres or something for a this algal bloom in the oceans.
Yeah.
But you think of how much space.
Surface area, yeah, in cities. Well, yeah, that green, part of the green tide proposal, we there's some links to some sites that provide green roofs. Green roofs? Roofs? Roofs?
Roofing.
Roof, as in America, rough. On a rough. On a roof. On a green roofs. So there are a way where you can have like a little ecosystem growing on your roof. And they've calculated that the total surface area of all the sort of houses in London is like the size of Richmond Park or something. So yeah, there is. If urban greening went ahead large scale and lots of funds went into it and we totally transformed cities so that there were plants and vegetation everywhere, then yeah, it probably would have a significant impact on reducing carbon dioxide, absorbing carbon dioxide. Well, it was interesting that Richard Branson and whoever did that, they've got that competition on at the moment, haven't they? Whoever comes up with a technological device or machine, some technological fix that can significantly reduce, absorb carbon dioxide, and they get some massive, you know, and you think, well, trees.
Yeah.
Trees and plants. No, we don't care about trees.
And it wouldn't cost, hardly anything.
No. But we like our technological fixes. If some scientist comes up with some machine, you know, that they can mass produce and stuff.
Yeah, that they can patent, yeah?
Yeah, patent. And, that seems to be what humans
especially if everyone has to buy one in order for it to work, the plan, yeah?
But that comes back to this idea that...
Like a catalytic converter or something.
It comes back to that idea about that we humans know best and we want to control everything. Whereas, as I say in the Metanoia film, that the more we can let nature do its thing, the better, you know.
Yeah. If we can help nature do its thing by leaving it alone and...
And making more of nature.
Yeah.
Making more... Increasing the spread of natural intelligence across the earth, you know. Encouraging biodiversity is the term I was looking for.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some good ideas there, yeah?
Yeah.
Simple ideas.
Worth thinking about. And they're all connected. What we've been talking about is all connected with the natural intelligence paradigm.
It's about making sense, isn't it?
Yeah.
In the context of global warming and stuff, using less energy makes sense, obviously.
Yeah.
And planting more greenery makes sense.
Yep. Especially when there's too much carbon dioxide in the environment, and we know that greenery, that plants and trees absorb this greenhouse gas. So. Mm-hmm. Natural intelligence.
You know it makes sense.
Yeah.